changes, Todd Holmberg!
Yeah!
Woo! Put your hands together for Todd Holmberg!
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you. I just want to give everyone a quick update on my rash. Doctor says I can still eat shrimp. Just not in that hot tub. Thank you. Thank you very much. It's been an exciting week for me. My wife and I are expecting.
Woo!
Yeah. We've been trying to decide on names. If it's a boy, my wife loves the name Ben. And if it's a girl, my wife loves the name Virginia. So earlier this week, we went in for an ultrasound, and not only did we discover we're having a girl, we're actually having conjoined twins. So I don't think that should be too big of an issue as far as the name goes. We'll probably just go Virginia and West Virginia. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Oh, I thought this was interesting. In England, up until about the 1500s, units of measurement were based on whoever was king at the time. So an inch was based on the king's finger, and a foot was actually based on the king's foot. And if you stepped outside and it was balmy, it was roughly the temperature of the king's balls. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you very much. I think it's interesting to me how certain types of animals have ways of warning people before they attack. Most famous is probably the rattlesnake. Before it bites, it'll shake the rattle. But scientists just discovered a new species of electric eel that when agitated, it will actually take its shoes off and go like this on the carpet. Aggressive males will sometimes even put on a thick wool sock. But seriously, early records show that the North American electric eel was actually discovered in the 1600s. However, electricity wasn't really developed until the 1700s. So for about 100 years there, it was simply referred to as the North American. Thank you. Thank you very much. Great crowd. Speaking of animals and injuries, I heard the other day that concussions in the animal kingdom are actually on the rise. Studies have shown that the bighorn sheep is most likely to suffer from a concussion. It's getting pretty bad, and the DNR is stepping in. They're going to start regulating the bighorn sheep mating ritual. In a statement released earlier this morning, the DNR says, starting in the fall of 2016, instead of slamming heads, males will be required to target the shoulder. If a male deliberately targets the head as the primary point of impact, he will be suspended for the remainder of the rut. Repeat offenders could face castration. DNR's not messing around. They're actually, for the long-term health of the herd, they're even proposing an eHarmony-like site for bighorn sheep to try to cut down on repeated blows to the head. What I wouldn't give to be a fly on the wall as a group of females checks out those profiles. Carol, go down to Steve. What does it say under Steve? Likes grass, can slam head good. Carol, go down to Greg. What does it say under Greg? Likes grass, can slam head good. I think you gotta go for it, Carol. I mean, I think that's pretty much all you've ever wanted in a man. And the clock's ticking. The clock's ticking. It's not like we're three anymore. Come on, Carol. What do you have to lose? It can't be worse than last mating season with, what was his name, Bill?
Come on. You didn't even like grass. Thank you. Good night.